Take the gun out. Put that right there.
Hey, what's up, people? I wanted to give you a recap of everything that happened basically in day six. Day six was my first full day of paleo. Kind of sitting here in the office right now. We got Julian chilling right next to us working on HUD. We got Jake over there in the background cranking out some BPOs. So basically, here's how the... And I'm going to show you little clips in between of the actual things, that I ate and stuff like that. But moral of the story, I started out the day just famished, finishing up the cleanse. And I had four eggs for breakfast. It was four eggs. It was a handful of spinach. It was half a bell pepper and then half an avocado. Just this huge breakfast. And I was literally... Like, I got the bowl, and I was like, just shoveling it in because I was so freaking hungry at that moment. That went really good. Lunch was really good. I'll show you guys the lunch. It was some great tasting tuna. And what's funny is that's actually going to be my lunch again on day seven, which is today, because I was unable to eat it all. I packed myself so much. Right before CrossFit, then, what I did was I ate that other half of avocado and a handful of nuts. And actually, during CrossFit, it turned out to be just way too much food. Made the stomach hurt a little bit. Today, I'm going to try just a small handful of the mixed nuts. I've still got them sitting right here. And then go from there. After dinner... So for dinner we had these fajitas right here, and you'll see them in just a second. Those fajitas, they were just awesome. I mean, the only thing that was missing for me was the actual tortilla. The funny thing about the fajitas is I had two giant fajitas, and about 9 o'clock at night, I was still really hungry. And Sarah and I were talking about this, and kind of what we're thinking is, we didn't get all of the carbs and stuff that we usually get, and so your body thinks it's still hungry. It's really funny phenomena. Like, I know I ate 2,000 plus calories, probably 2,500, maybe even 3,000 yesterday, and I felt slightly hungry all day. I don't know if my body will adjust to this over time or if it'll just continue down this path. But before that, I went to CrossFit. CrossFit was a really good workout. Basically, we did, it was a 500 meter run, and then 10 air squats, 10 toes to bar, 10 push-ups, 10 jumping lunges, 10 back extensions, and 10 sit-ups for two rounds. That was kind of, the warm-up. And then we worked a little bit on form, and then the strength and skill portion, which was the next portion, we basically we did deadlifts and handstand push-ups. And so did two sets of deadlifts to warm up. I did, and I'm looking down at my notes, sorry about that. I did 135 for 10, and then did a set of 225 for 10. And then the workout itself was supposed to be, you do four at a heavy weight, rest 20 seconds, do max handstand push-ups, wait 2 minutes, repeat for four rounds. And basically, so when I went into it, my first set, I did 225, rested my 20 seconds. I was actually able to do seven handstand push-ups yesterday, and that's the first time I've ever cranked out that many, so I was real excited. Rested, then I did 245, six handstand push-ups, handstand push-ups started to plummet after that. I did 265 for my next set of deadlifts. I was only able to get three. And then four handstand push-ups, finished it off with 285 for the 285 for the deadlifts. Got three of those, just barely. Definitely grunting out my last one. And was only able to get three handstand push-ups, and then I fell off the wall. I was like, another funny thing that happens to me is I actually have to cartwheel. I can't cartwheel up onto the wall. I have to put my legs up and wheelbarrow back in. So I'm in the middle of my third one, lifting myself, and I get all the way up and extended, and I was like, extend, bring myself down, right arm gave way, boom, just kind of fell off the wall. Anyway, thought that was kind of funny. The next part of the workout was a 12-minute AMRAP of kind of a heavy kettlebell swing. It was a 53-pound kettlebell for 15, and then double unders, 30 double unders, and I suck at double unders. The first two rounds, I was able to do basically a double, then a single, a double, then a single, a double, then a single. And then after that, because I was kind of getting tired, my form just fell apart. So I ended up basically doing a double every now and again, mostly singles. And somehow I whipped myself in the hand. You can see that red mark. It was actually really bright last night while I was doing double unders. Showed this to Sarah, my wife, and she was like, you know, you're such an idiot. I don't know how you would pile yourself into the hand with a jump rope when most of the time you're only going to whip yourself in the back of the leg. Anyway, so that was my workout. That's what I ate. Next, I'm just going to show you breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And then I'll cut that shit. Thank you guys for watching. And sorry.